Welcome back to what I think will be the last video that will show a proof of one of the properties of hyperbolic functions. Here are the six hyperbolic functions that by now we should be familiar with. If we take a look at some of the properties of these functions, we're going to focus on this property here for this video. We're going to prove hyperbolic sine squared of x is equal to the quantity negative 1 plus hyperbolic cosine of 2x divided by 2. So let's go ahead and get started. So to start, we're going to go ahead and write both sides of the equation in exponential form. And if needed, we can use the notes provided here below in red, here and here, to write these functions in exponential form. For hyperbolic sine squared of x, we would have e to the power of x minus e to the negative x divided by 2 squared. And then for the right side, notice how we'd have a denominator of 2. And then in the numerator, we would have negative 1 plus hyperbolic cosine of 2x, which would be e to the power of 2x plus e to the power of negative 2x divided by 2. And now for our proof, we're going to work at the right side to make it look like the left side. And to start off, we want to clear the fraction in the numerator. So what we can do is multiply both the numerator by 2 and the denominator by 2. And since 2 over 2 is equal to 1, this is like multiplying by 1, and therefore it doesn't change the value. So notice how we'd have a denominator of 4, and if we distribute in the numerator, we would have negative 2, and then we'd have plus e to the 2x plus e to the negative 2x. Notice how we can already write 4 as 2 squared, so our denominators match up, which means in order for these to be equal, this numerator must be factorable. So let's go ahead and change the order of the terms. We're going to write 4 as 2 squared. Let's go ahead and write the numerator as e to the 2x minus 2 plus e to the negative 2x. And again, in order for these to be equal, this must be factorable, and it must factor into two factors of e to the x minus e to the negative x. So let's go ahead and try to factor it and see if it works. We want two equal factors of e to the 2x, which would be e to the x and e to the x. Remember, if we multiply these, we would add the exponents, and x plus x is equal to 2x. We also want two equal factors of e to the negative 2x, which would be e to the negative x and e to the negative x. Again, if we multiply these factors, we would add the exponents. Negative x plus negative x is equal to negative 2x. And because this last term is positive, but the middle term is negative, that means these both must be minuses. Now to check to make sure this is factored correctly, we know that the inner product and outer product
must have a sum of negative 2.
Let's go ahead and check that. E to the x times negative e to the negative x, we would add the exponents, that would give us negative e to the 0 plus negative e to the negative x times e to the x would be, again, negative e to the 0. Well, anything to the 0 power is equal to 1, so this is negative 1 plus negative 1, which does equal negative 2, which means this is factored correctly. And that's good news, because notice how we have two equal factors in the numerator, two equal factors in the denominator. Therefore, we can write this as e to the x minus e to the negative x divided by 2 squared, which matches the left side of the equation exactly. Therefore, we have our proof. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.